I'm going to talk to you about an amazing writer, D.H. Lawrence. D.H. Lawrence was born in 1885 in the mining village of Eastwood. You know that Eastwood appears as Bestwood in Sons and Lovers. The nearby town is Nottinghamshire. It was a coal mining town. Lawrence's father was a coal miner. Mother had middle class ambitions. Lawrence did not like coal mining because it destroyed the English countryside. Lawrence's mother also wanted her children to do something beyond coal mining. She wanted her children to be middle class, like Gertrude Morrell in Sons and Lovers. Lawrence became a school teacher, a poet, and a novelist. As a novelist, he was a modernist, but as a poet, he was romantic. He was Georgian. He wrote very simple kind of poetry. He eloped with his professor's wife, Frieda Weekly. That was the first rebellion in his life against conventional morality. And afterwards, he conducted travels of his own. He traveled, he wrote about it. There were also sexual experiments he did, which nearly wrecked his marriage. Finally, he was diagnosed with tuberculosis, and he died very early at the age of 44. As you know, some of his works have been banned for obscenity. Some of his works have a lot of, most of his works, in fact, have a lot of depiction of sexuality. His novels are written in a highly poetic language with autobiographical elements and show influence of Sigmund Freud and other thinkers of the time. These novels are not experiments in terms of form like James Joyce did, for example. Lawrence depicted the clash between social classes, between sexes, between man and woman, the clash between mind and body. And he also used modernist devices like free indirect speech, psychological realism, a very symbolic or metaphoric language, etc. The Rainbow and Lady Chatterley's Lover, these two were banned in his lifetime. He represented sexuality in his novels as a symbol or as metaphoric of the condition of the human beings of that time. There are two kinds of life that he depicted. A natural life, living in close proximity to nature, realizing the sources of your life or blood consciousness, that is natural life, which is what Lady Chatterley discovers in her sexual affair with Oliver Mellors. The other kind of life that he depicts is a slowly decaying life, a civilization of death. You probably know that Lawrence was also a critic. He wrote about Walt Whitman. He wrote about Thomas Hardy. Lawrence had a very close affinity towards these two writers. Lawrence had a very close affinity with Thomas Hardy and Walt Whitman. All of them talked about nature and an essential elemental state of man beyond civilization. And Lawrence also talked about the novel as one bright book of life. You know that, I guess. His major poetry collections are Birds, Beasts and Flowers. He wrote tortoises, poems about tortoises as symbol. He has also written short stories and plays. But before that, let me introduce the novels. Lawrence's first published novel was The White Peacock. And the protagonist is Letitia or Letty. That was the original title of the novel as well. And it was based on a painting, actually. This novel was inspired by a painting by Griefenhagen. The setting is Nethermere, a fictional place, modeled on Eastwood only. And the story is narrated by Cyril Beardsall, who is our Letty's brother. Many plot elements and characters in The White Peacock parallel Lawrence's later works. The Sons and Lovers came in 1913. In between, there was a second play, novel called The Trespasser, which is not very famous. Sons and Lovers is a Bildungsroman. employing psychological realism, and it is so closely based on Lawrence's life that he found it very difficult to write this novel. There were many false starts and interruptions. He had to revise it. The first title was Paul Morrell, as you might know. The editor of the novel, Edward Garnett, that is the dedicatee of the novel also. The novel is dedicated to Edward Garnett. The novel begins with Gertrude Morrell's perceptions and experiences. She's very much attached to her first son, William. She loves her husband, but cares for him, but she is fed up with his lower class nature. She wants to be upper class or middle class. She wants her children to have a better life. She is sacrificing everything for her children. She does not want another child, but she is now pregnant with a third child. So we see her perceptions. And then slowly, William, the first son, grows up. And he starts doing things that Gertrude doesn't fully approve of. But Gertrude is a wonderful woman. She does not choke her son. She does not control him too much. When he falls in love with a girl called Louisa Weston, she doesn't approve of this girl. Gertrude Morrell doesn't like this girl, but she insists that William should not ill-treat her. She should treat her properly. And then suddenly William dies of pneumonia. And Gertrude is so devastated. She stops talking and she's so sad. And then it was when Paul, the third son, also falls ill that she suddenly recovers and turns all her attention on Paul. From this point, Paul becomes the narrator. He tries to live a normal life. He meets one girl, Miriam, tries to be friends with her, falls in love, spends a lot of time with her working in the beautiful nature, in the company of nature. But he feels so sensitive towards his mother. His mother is sacrificing everything. She is such a wonderful woman. And he understands that she cannot love any other woman. He cannot love any other woman. He also tries to have a physical relationship with Miriam, but Miriam is a very rigid kind of religious girl. She doesn't enjoy it. And later he meets Clara, an older woman, and has a beautiful sexual relationship with her, but he can't have her. Clara has a husband and she goes back to him. Miriam is attached to his mother and his mother is dying. His mother gets a tumor and she silently suffers. Miriam and her sister and his sister Annie are taking care of her. Finally, he gives her an overdose of the painkiller morphium and kills her out of love. And he doesn't know what is going to be there in the future for him. That is how the novel ends. He walks towards the glowing lights of the town. He can't just get over his attachment to his mother. And Lawrence has said that this is the tragedy of many young men in England. Two novels came after this, The Rainbow and Women in Love. They were companion novels all about the Brangwen family. In Rainbow, there's a lot of depiction of sexuality. Three couples are depicted. Tom and Lydia. Lydia's daughter, Anna and Will. And then their daughter, Ursula, and her boyfriend, Anton. These are the couples. All of them are intelligent people, fighting all the time. There is star equilibrium between, Lawrence's couples, men and women. They fight a lot. They repel as well as attract. And in The Rainbow, at the end, what is life like? What are life's choices? Ursula sees a rainbow in the sky and she gets hope for the future. That is why it is called Rainbow. The same Ursula and her sister Gudrun are characters in Women in Love. There also star equilibrium is there. So much attraction between men and women. Even between men and men, homosociality, homoeroticism is there in Lawrence. But also repulsion, fighting. Ursula marries Birkin. Gudrun and Gerald Critch are in love, but fighting, and Gerald Critch finally dies. Our Birkin is having an attachment with Gerald. This is the story of women in love. Beautiful, symbolic, poetic narratives. There are three novels called leadership novels. Aaron's Rod, Kangaroo and The Plumed Serpent. And Kangaroo is set in Australia, Plumed Serpent in Mexico. There are some other novels also that he has written. All of them are not very important. But Lady Chatterley's Lover is important. In Lady Chatterley's Lover, there is Connie or Constance Chatterley. She is married to Clifford. He is bedridden. Not bedridden, wheelchair ridden. And he cares only for himself. He doesn't care for his wife. Connie starts an affair with an educated servant, a gamekeeper, Oliver Mellos. And she discovers herself. She discovers life, beauty, sexuality. And she gets pregnant and there is the hope that they will get divorced, each of them, Mellors and Connie, and finally they will get married. That is the hope. Lawrence has also written travelogues. When he traveled, he wrote Twilight in Italy, Sea and Sardinia, Mornings in Mexico and Etruscan Places. I told you he has written short stories like England, My England, Horse Dealer's Daughter, The Odor of Chrysanthemums, etc. His plays include Collier's Friday Night. Cotter's Saturday Night, which is Collier's Friday Night is modeled on Cotter's Saturday Night by Burns. Then The Daughter-in-Law is another play. Widowing of Mrs. Holroyd, etc. So that is in a nutshell about Lawrence, D.H. Lawrence. He has also written about two books on Freudian psychoanalysis. Very important concept in understanding for Lawrence's characters is blood consciousness, where women and men try to connect with the roots or the sources of their life. Women especially. And sexuality is one means of getting connected back to their roots. That is blood consciousness. So please read D.H. Lawrence, read about him more. I hope this video will help you. Thank you very much.